Barb coming through my craft studio. I have a haul to share. I went out shopping yesterday. I think it's just Dollar Tree and Hobby Lobby. Mainly clearance at Hobby Lobby. But at Dollar Tree, I picked up this wreath hanger. They have a pink one and a light blue one this year for Easter. I hadn't seen those colors before. I was like, oh, I've never seen pastels before. And the employee was putting them out, goes, yeah, these are brand new for this year, so... No, that is a new Dollar Tree, so maybe they've had them before, and she just didn't know it, but I never seen them either. And I found these fortune cookies that I thought would just be cute to put in the neighbor kids' little bags that I'm going to make for them. I always like these little sixlets, so I usually pick those at Dollar Tree. I did not need stickers, but they were just so timely and so cute that I picked them up. It seems like I rarely find this type of seasonal sticker at the season. I mean, I'll find their other ones that they have, but a lot of times the ones that are in the more seasonal area, these were just sort of by the craft things, are more kid-like. And then I bought three sets of the bags. Bags each. This one. It was one I really liked. It was purple, but it had pink and purple hearts on it. But it was all the way at the back of the thing, and I didn't feel like taking everything off in front of it and grab it just to get that one. So I just went with these three sets instead. And then at Hobby Lobby, this item was just on sale. I needed more of the album refills for the 12x12 page protectors, so I picked up that package. And then I think everything else was clearance. I found a couple things in the art department. I found this pen. I think this may have been the brand I was looking at to buy on Amazon, and they kept being out of stock in it. It's in Japanese, so it's hard to say. And then I found this set of Zig calligraphy pens. I keep having good intentions of practicing my lettering. And I did get my lettering station set up, so I'm hoping maybe I can get that. I've got a lot of things I need to get done before I practice that, though. And then I found these repositionable glue dots on clearance. I was looking, I went over by the adhesive stuff because I was looking for Gorilla Glue because I seen in somebody's clearance video, they were just filming in Hobby Lobby and I seen a thing of Gorilla Glue, but they didn't have any marked down at my store. I said, now it's really strange because it seems like just about all of the Halloween stickers are on clearance. That struck me as odd when I didn't see any other ones, but maybe they're just doing them in waves and there's going to be other seasons clearance later. But I picked up this one. I thought it would be cute in my planner, actually. And then I picked up a couple of these envelopes. Thought they'd be cute for birthday cards. And then I found this page kit. It's by Photo Play. It's called Summer Daydreams. It's by Tracy Smith. I thought that it was cute. And then I found the Bundle of Joy, a new edition by Alicia Gordon, by Echo Park, in the boy colors. I had already bought the girl colors at my other Hobby Lobby over the weekend, and I found this one yesterday at the second Hobby Lobby. I live in a really small town, so there's no place to shop in my town. There's a grocery store, and that's pretty much it. And there's a couple of little specialty shops downtown, but most of them don't sell. There is a quilt shop, but I haven't been going in there. I have enough fabric, so it's like, stay out of there. Doesn't stop me from going in craft stores, but you know. So we have to drive to one city or the other. Usually we go to the bigger city. There's kind of a small city and then a big city. And it has a Hobby Lobby on one side of town and another Hobby Lobby on the other side. And same thing with Michael's. But there's only one Joann, and it's a small Joann. I really wish that they would build another Joann on the other side of town and make it a bigger one. I think they could use it. I think they'd do well because the other one is always super crowded. But anyways, that's all that I bought. I found out Tiffany is not going to be at the Schaumburg Expo this year, so I'm debating whether I'm going to go or not. I've been saving my money because there were several organizing things that I was hoping to pick up at the expo from her. I really need to try to get what I have organized before I buy a whole lot more, so I'm not sure. Maybe I'll just skip going to expo this year. I do have several doctor appointments. I basically got like 7 days of vacation planned this year already, and they're all doctor appointments for this girl. I go to the podiatrist next week. They want to be, since the swelling shows in an x-ray on the tissue, they want to see what's going on there, what's causing that. So she referred me to a podiatrist, so I see him next week. The swelling has been going. At first it started off kind of intermittent back in 2013, and it kind of stayed that way till like 2 years ago, and then 2 years ago it just became a daily thing that my ankles were swollen. Sometimes they're just a little puffy, and other days they're huge. And I kept telling my doctors and telling my doctors, and they kept saying, it's not swollen, or that's normal. And I was like, no, it's not. So finally this new primary care physician said, yeah. She goes, they told you that? I said, yeah. I said, they told me my legs weren't swollen at all. And I said, when I went up to Mayo, they said, yes, they are. And she got down, she pushed in, and she comes out, she goes, this is the way you test for it. And I'm like, yeah, they don't do that. They just look at them. And she goes, they are definitely swollen. She goes, even having been on the water pill for 2 months, you still have swelling in your legs. I said, yeah, they do look a lot better than they had, especially the ankles. The ankles have look a lot better, but there is still swelling there. So we'll see how that goes. And then I go back to see the new primary care physician in March because she wants to follow up because she changed my blood pressure meds. I haven't even started the new one yet because I'm going to finish up what I had of the old one because I only had like a week's extra week's worth to finish. So I figured I'll just wait and finish it that way. It's always nice to have a little bit extra on hand in case something happens and you can't get to the pharmacy because of weather or whatever. So I'm hoping to just wait because she asked if I had the cough from the other one. And I said, yeah, I have developed it. I said, it seems a little better, but it seems to happen mainly now when I go to bed. When I lay down, I start coughing. She's like, is it bad enough that you want to switch? And I'm like, well, it's not horrible. And she goes, well, if it bugs you at all, we can go ahead and switch it. I can give you one that doesn't do that. And I said, you know what? The other ones do is pretty much almost out. I'm almost out of it. So it's time to get a refill sent in soon anyway. So why don't we just go ahead and switch it? So I'll start that probably maybe the beginning of next week, probably Sunday. I lay them out for a week at a time when I do my meds. So hopefully. And then later in March, I have an appointment with my migraine specialist. I see him, well, it usually ends up her. I usually see the assistant every like 6 months. I do have to talk to her because the meds they prescribe me for when I get a migraine to take, my insurance will no longer pay for. So they're going to have to, I do have a little bit of a stockpile. Thank goodness that I did that. I was questioning whether I should or shouldn't do that, and I just decided, you know what, I'm going to go ahead and just get it every month whether I need it or not, and I'm glad I did because now I have enough to get through a few more months, whereas if I hadn't, I'd be just about out, and it really works well for me, so I hate to switch meds, but I know I'm going to have to. And then in April, I have 3 days of appointments over a 5-day period in Bale. I'm going to see the pulmonologist again. I'm going to have an EMG. They're going to do an X, overnight oximetry, I'm probably not pronouncing that right, reading. It's where they measure your oxygen intake, the little thing on your finger measure your oxygen intake, and I think it also takes your pulse. They want to see how my breathing is at night. I think they kind of think that maybe that's where the problem is initiating. Maybe I'm having problems overnight, which is causing the issues with activity during the day. So we'll see how that goes. And then I'm going to be go to the fibromyalgia clinic, get a exam and evaluation, and then fibromyalgia education, because they think that I have fibromyalgia too. She's thinking, have you ever been diagnosed with that? I'm like, well, yes. I said, but they go back and forth. I was told in 2012 that I had it. And then a few months later, they said, no, that's not what this is. And so they sent me up to get more done up at UW. And that's when they diagnosed with the connective tissue disease. And then last year, with that appointment, he'd been saying for months that when I had contacted him, that it was probably arthritis in my jaw, hips, knees. He said those three places. I suspected a few other places, but those were the three that he said I had arthritis. But he didn't do any imaging. So at my last appointment, I asked, can we do something to confirm whether it's arthritis or not? Because my feeling is if it's arthritis, we need to see what type of arthritis, and we need to do something about it, because arthritis damages your joints. So why would you not treat it at all? Especially if it's something other than just related to age. And when I pushed for that, he says, you're getting fibromyalgia. That's what this is. And I'm like, for months it's been arthritis, and now that I'm pushing for a diagnosis on that, it's fibromyalgia. So I wasn't happy with him. So he actually recommended a different doctor on my next visit when I go in May. Who specializes in Sjogren's, which is what they think I have. So I'm not going back to him. I decided after the Mayo trip, I said, I'm just switching doctors. It was after the first trip that I took in November. I'm just switching doctors. I'm going to switch my primary care, get her in the same network as under the UW umbrella, even though my rheumatologist is in another state, but it's still under the same umbrella so they can at least see each other's. So they can communicate with each other and then see this new doctor in at UW. I am even considering, especially if I see this new one and I don't really care for them, of just seeing about finding one down here. I know that they kind of have a shortage of rheumatologists in this area, but my new primary care did say that they had one that is pretty good, and says he can usually pinpoint these tricky cases, so she says you might want to consider seeing him, so we'll see there. I am hoping that I can convince some doctor along the way to do imaging the jaw, maybe recheck the spine to see if that's gotten worse, if that's causing the shoulder issues. The rheumatologist said it was tendonitis in my shoulder, but again, did nothing to confirm that. Said, oh, it's tendonitis. So I'd like to find out for sure if that's what it is. And then I'd also like to know if the hips and knees, if it's arthritis, bursitis, tendonitis, or just inflammation. But they're going to have to do imaging because a lot of it is elimination. You can't just say, oh, it's this. Because unless you've done imaging to rule out certain things, you can't say that for sure. So that's where I stand. I am almost out of time, so I'm going to thank you for joining me, and I'm hoping to get some cracking done and be sharing that soon, and of course more updates on my organization. Thanks for joining me. I'll catch you next time.